we are going to discuss and see today is to observe pollen germination on a slide. For this, we will be needing flowers, slides. It is a special slide called cavity slide. It is a small depression on it. This is which we are going to use for that. Need a cover slip, needle, and we need a special nutrient medium which consists of sucrose, calcium nitrate and boric acid in a proper proportion. This is the solution which will help in the germination of a pollen. Now we will take a cavity slide. With the help of a dropper, we will put 2 drops of the nutrient medium, 2 to 3 drops of nutrient medium in the cavity. We will take a pollen, an anther. With the help of a needle, we will dust a few pollens in the nutrient medium. Then, with the help of a cover slip, we will cover this. Take care that there should be no air bubbles at the time of placement of cover slip. Now, the pollens are in the nutrient medium and we have to keep them aside for about half an hour to observe the germination of pollen. It is not that you will be able to see the germination of all the pollens, because their pollen tube arises only from the germ pole. If it is placed in a proper position, only then the germination of the pollen can be observed. We are going to start the first practical, that is to observe pollen germination on slide in a nutrient medium. For this experiment, what we need is, we will be needing a special slide called cavity slide, which has a small depression in it, a cover slip and a special nutrient medium which contains water, sucrose, boric acid and calcium nitrate in a proper proportion. We are going to put 3 to 4 drops of this nutrient medium in the cavity. Then we will pluck one anther from the flower, and with the help of a needle we will dust small amount of pollen on the cavity medium. Now with the help of a forceps, we will put the cover slip on the cavity. Please take care that there should be no air gap, no air bubble while you are placing the cover slip. Use a needle for the same purpose and slowly remove the needle so that there is no air bubble. Now, this slide is to be kept aside for about half an hour before you observe the germination of pollen grain. You cannot see all the pollens germinating because the pollens have germ pore through which the pollen tubes arise. If the pollen is placed in a proper manner on the slide, only then the pollen germination of that pollen can be observed. Otherwise, you can observe a few pollens germinating in the slide. After half an hour, you are going to observe this slide under the microscope. And what you observe will be small tube-like structures arising from these pollens. Small structures, small projections arising from these pollens. And this is to be recorded and shown to the examiner. This experiment deals with the position of a temporary mount of onion root tips to observe stages of mitosis. Mitosis is the cell division which takes place in all the somatic cells of all the living organisms and helps in growth of the body. This is observed in case of plants and animals both. But for the preparation of slide, we are going to use plant material which is the onion root tips, which contain the meristematic region where the cell division goes on continuously, and we are going to use the same for the purpose. The requirement is slice root tips of onion, needle, blotting paper, blade, spirit lamp, and a special staining agent called acetocarbon. This is used here because DNA takes a very good stain with acetocarbon. Now we are going to take a root here and we will look for the meristematic region. Here you can see that one end of the root here is very dark. It is dark white in color, and we are going to put this on the slide, and with the help of a blade we will take only the darker portion on the slide. We will cut the tip of this here and throw away the rest of the material. This root tip contains the meristematic region. On this root tip we are going to put 2 to 3 drops of acetocarbon, and it with the help of spirit lamp we are going to heat this. As the plant cell material contains cell wall, it needs to be stained through the cell wall to the nucleus to observe the stages of mitosis. In between we are going to cut the material into smaller pieces so that it is easier for you to see the stained cells. Repeat the procedure, adding some more stain and heat it once again. Don't overheat it, and it should not be done continuously on the flame, otherwise the material will get burned. Now you can take another slide and transfer the material from this slide onto the other slide. Put glycerin over it, about 2 drops, and with the help of a cover slip, you are going to cover this up. Use a needle for putting the cover slip. If there is any bubble visible, you can remove it with the help of a needle, and there should be enough glycerin so that when there is putting up of the cover slip, it is put properly. Slowly, at angle of 45 degree, start putting the cover slip, keeping a needle underneath it and slowly removing it. As this is put on slide, now it is the most important part of separating the cells of the root tip. For this we do tapping. What is to be done, that you take blotting paper and seeing that where your material is being placed, you cover this with the blotting paper, hold the cover slip and the slide with your finger, and with the help of a broad pen or a pencil, start tapping it. The pressure should not be too much, otherwise the cover slip will break, but it should be enough to separate the material. See, the cells have started separating. you will continue with this till you see that the cells have got properly separated. You can see that the cells have started pulling themselves away from each other and they are getting separated. Repeat this. Holding the slide as well as the cover slip, and pressure should not be too much, otherwise the cover slip will break. Now you can observe this slide under the microscope. Since there are a large number of cells in this slide, you will have to look for the stages in a proper manner. After observing the slide under the microscope, if you feel that the cells are still not separated, you can again repeat that. Under the microscope, you should be able to see the cells away from each other. They should not be binded together. Once this is done, you are going to observe it under 10x microscope and you will be observing different stages of mitosis. Here you can see it's a normal cell with a prophase, where you can see the thickening of chromosomes. The chromosome thread will appear darker to you. At mitosis, you will see that the chromosomes have moved towards the center of the cell at the equatorial plate. Next stage is anaphase, where you can see the chromosomes pulled away towards the two poles. And the last stage of telophase, you can see that there are two separate nuclei and they are bounded or covered with a nuclear membrane. It means that the last stage of mitosis is over and two daughter cells have been formed.